A teenager with no underlying health conditions has died after testing positive. The 17-year-old was one of 279 people who died from coronavirus in the past 24 hours. The deaths bringing the total number of confirmed fatalities in hospitals in England to 83,529. The patients were aged between 17 and 102 years, all except 11 of them, aged 17 to 89 years old, had underlying. Last month, a 16-year-old without any underlying conditions also died from the bug. Vaccine trials on children as young as 5 are set to begin soon, paving the way for a future childhood immunist. Pfizer is starting a trial for children aged 5 to 11, while Oxford AstraZeneca's trial will focus on youngsters aged 6 to 17. Medics believe youngsters given the jab could develop lifelong immunity. Jabs by July. Meanwhile, Health Secretary Matt Hancock said today that the UK is on track for all adults to be jabbed by July as vaccines will be ramped up this. Mr. Hancock also provided an update to MPs on the latest information on the new strain, which has been found in 6 people in the UK so far. He told the Commons this afternoon, "This country is on the road to recovery. We have freedom. Let's not waver and do whatever it takes to keep it under control." He said that after a lumpy supply this month which had led to some drops in the numbers, but they were expecting a huge ramping up. The hospital admissions were falling faster than new cases, he confirmed today. The having time of hospital admissions is now at 18 days, but for over 80s it's 12 days as so many have been jabbed, he said. He said, "This is real-world evidence that the vaccine is protecting the NHS and saving lives." And he referenced fresh research from PHE that both vaccines have led to a more than 80% reduction in hospitalists, so people can have confidence.